If you sell a lot.
You see now measuring temperature on the.
Yes. This on the other side, you have to measure.
Yes.
You can see it also. Have a look here.
Here inside you have one sensor for humidity. Okay.
And one for temperature.
No, it's always the same inside, okay? You measure both.
Oh, okay.
And it's, if you hear the noise, it's the ventilator. The ventilator takes the air from here through here, but takes the air through here, okay? And so the sensor is mounted here, if you see.
Okay.
Come up. Regulates then, or see the temperature.
So
it's always important that you have this noise, because else you don't have the same temperature. You know?
Yeah, I know.
It's different. Yeah, it could be, for example, 2-3 degrees more.
Yeah. No, I think now humidity is low.
I will show you. You see one time the temperature alone, the humidity alone, and both together, like we saw.
Yeah.
The second here you have all information about sensors, okay? How we see here, how I told you already. Air temperature, for example, -5.5. Then we have the relative humidity, 78%. Here is the, this both together, okay? Here you will see after the pressure for the water flow. It means how much steps I have opened, how I regulate. Water temperature, the gun, when you start it, they must be have always about 2 degrees before they start to open the motors, okay, for testing like this. Or also, if you start it hand, okay, mode, you have to start first the heating. And look on this temp, for sure you will get a better snow quality, okay? For example, we decide now to change to manual mode, to hand mode. Push one time here. You see, you choose, and always with OK, you say OK.
Sure
I go now. Yes, to hand mode. Now you saw it was changing here the controls. What's coming now? That means now I have to start all by hand, heating the compressor. The turbine, light if I want.
Yes.
Valve, it means the steps, how much I want to open in front. It's cold, it's not cold, I decide. And the hydrant, but the hydrant here is in New York. Here you have different because you don't have automatic hydrant. You have to open by hand. Okay? The infos are always the same. Like always the same information, doesn't matter if I'm in automatic or in manual mode. And in the settings, I see I can change now, back to the automatic mode. Go here one time, when it's getting yellow, push and say automatic.
And OK.
And OK. This we saw already. In automatic mode, I can choose the quality of snow, for example. Because I say, how we said before, I want a dry snow, or I want a wet snow.
During the work.
You can change also. It's not that.
So they don't draw.
You will change here, okay? Then the gun looks always on the temperatures for sure, and he say then okay, I close. For example, valve motor 4, okay, means that I open another one. So you have more flow, or it's up. If you want fryer, for sure, maybe it's closing one valve motor. If you want ready, maybe it's coming one more, like for the steps.
If you want to change, it's no problem.
You say, for example, you put 4, with the OK button, and now you see, we stopped the 4. Maximum pressure relief, like, service temperature. This is important for the automatic mode, because here is like that the gun don't start you before we have -2.5 degrees. Okay, valve, not only only temperature is the combination, the world part, okay, from the humidity and the temperature.
Danas opet kod hale. Ovaj, imamo novine što se ski centra tiče. Tu smo sa našim Radetom entuzijastom i sa gospodinom
Mladen Đurićem.
Mladenom Đurićem, koji će malo da nam kažu nešto o ovoj spravici koja je sad tu iza njih. Izvolite.
Pa ako generalno, znači, pre nekoliko, da kažem, pre 2 do 3 godine se ekipa mladih ljudi skupila sa željom da pokrene revitalizaciju ski centra. I već smo tada razmišljali da bi mu u perspektivi bilo dobro imati ovakve neke spravice koje garantuju stvaranje snega kada za to postoje uslovi, a kada nema padavina. Tako da smo tada još bili kontaktirali ovu kompaniju. Ove godine smo kroz projekat Pokrenimo Rajko doveli njih i tako da smo tada ispitivali mogućnosti da se ovakav sistem i ovde primeni. I nakon naših razgovora oni su došli na ideju, italijanska kompanija Technoalpin, došli na ideju da jedan ovakav top nama pozajmi na godinu do dve, da bismo videli da li u našim uslovima on može da radi i kako radi, a da bismo ujedno uradili promociju tih sistema, jer svi ski centri i po svetu, a čak i u Srbiji, Stara planina, Koponik, Zlatibor, Kraljevica, svi imaju ovakve sisteme. I to bi generalno mnogo, mnogo značilo i za Rajko, jer bi time imali sezonu možda već u decembru i moglo bi nešto da se planira u tom smislu, u smislu turizma. Nije, ne bi bila tako velika investicija, ali mislim da bi čitava zajednica dosta dobila kupovinu ovog sistema.
Hvala, Mladene, Rade.
Pa ništa, ono što imam da dodam, to je da su sada ljudi iz Technoalpina došli i nebrijeno pokazali kako zapravo to funkcioniše i isprobali sa nama tu mašinu i uputili nas u neko uputstvo, tačnije kako je dalje možemo koristiti. Sada će naravno i naši gledalci, to jest vaši gledalci i oni svi koji se uključivali u projekat Pokrenimo Rajkovo i revitalizaciju ski centra Rajkovo i da vide kako zapravo on funkcioniše. Nadamo se da će uskoro biti postavljen na nekom od terena, da li je Bangladeš ili gore kod one krivine u elektroniku, gde će deca naravno moći da uživaju u napravljenom snegu od topa koje smo dobili od Technoalpina, kojima se i ovog puta zahvaljujemo od srca.
Hvala i tebi, Rade, i srećom za sve ostale poduhvate.
Hvala, srećno svima nama.
Hvala.
Prijatno.
Alps!
push here, you can decide how much they will go open. Because we are now in manual mode.
Yeah.
For example, they will show you now, you're always now in open step 3, okay? In front here.
Omladinski projekat Pokrenimo Rajkovo sprovodi neformalna grupa mladih ski entuzijasti uz podršku Resurs centra Bor, a u okviru programa Mladi su zakon koji finansira Ministarstvo omladine i sporta. Čitavu ideju pokretanja ski centra podržala je i podržava lokalna samouprava koja je od samog početka prepoznala potencijal samog ski centra i sve što njegov rad sa sobom donosi. To su pre svega nasmejana i zadovoljna lica skijaša i bordera, a poslije i razvoj zimskih turističkih ponuda i kapaciteta u samoj opštini Majdanpek.